What's up, guys? ACL, JP, Jacob, Clam, or Jacob, and I'm back with you guys. QB1 Face of the Franchise, Episode 6. So we're gonna play the Raiders. Try to get to the regular season. So here you go. A scrambling quarterback, you know I can't run, but here you go. Hopefully it'll be a better game. Because that last game, I literally did, like, nothing. Daniel Brown. The Raiders. Yeah, because it's definitely on the Raiders. Definitely. Oh, DJ Torrance, sir.
Flushed out right. And his pass incomplete.
I hate being 6'4", 220, like.
Fourth round guy, and many thought that's about where he would go, but I think he's got some upside, right?
He can come right in and be what they call a core special teams player, play on all four phases of it, and have a chance to work his way into the lineup. I think a year or two.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. From 17 yards. Fake on the give here as they try to run pass.
Oh, that's a one-on-one, man. You got to
be after a gain of 5 up to the 25-yard line. Here's a second and 5 now from the 25. This is David Johnson, the former All-Pro. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34.
Johnson early and often, dude.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
Love being left-handed.
He gets it in the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 12 yards to pick up. Good enough for an Arizona first. The 11-time Pro Bowler Larry Fitzgerald still has it. His production did take a dip last year on the heels of 3 straight 1,000-yard campaigns. He's in the back half of his 30s now. What a career it's been. Coming into this year, over 1,300 receptions, 116 of those for touchdowns, and second only to Jerry Rice in career receiving yards. Pretty spectacular. And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. Looking to throw.
Oh, nice throw.
Incomplete. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move.
That was
first down. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Back in Arizona, second quarter action. It's the Cardinals in possession as they've got it with a 1st and 10. A first down carry here for Johnson.
Dude, gotta go forward, man. Or gotta juke.
As they stop him behind the line. A full 5-yard loss that time. It's gonna make second down pretty tough. 2nd and 15. It's caught by Crabtree. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Ran a perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone.
fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it.
That would have worked, but I thought Johnson was the
once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Second and 10. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Now they'll try to convert on third and 6 after the 4-yard completion. They'll look to throw here. And he's got his man. It's the tight end play. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Here's second and 8.
P.I., that's P.I.
Flag comes in as that one falls incomplete.
Yes.
Well, let's see who this is on. So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Man, keep packing with like speed, dude.
And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and three. Eluding the pressure right.
What a throw.
Position on him, and he pulls it in.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
Now back to throw.
Now stepped up right into
the
sack.
Just inside the 20 at the 19. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. He'll look to throw.
Oh, he got a catch, man. Possession
catch. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. The Cardinals on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 15. He'll drop to throw. Over the middle and caught by the tight end Clay. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 4. So it's a win here for the Arizona Cardinals. And it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises. Really, both sides did. But they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. But
I'm trying to get to the right good season before I end this. Episode CX. It was actually a decent game, other than a couple of plays. Good point with that. That'll make the team. The quarterback, the blockers, the receivers. Once it's in the regular. Oh, don't get caught.
Start your week by installing your game plan.
Playing three quarters. Okay, so after this game, I'm probably gonna end the episode because it's gonna take long. The next game, I'm probably playing 4 quarters. So fucking cool. Yeah.
everybody. It's the coach. Welcome to the special Saturday edition of the NFL.
I don't care if it's Saturday. It's preseason. There you go. Let's start this game off good. It said don't. It says get a touchdown and don't throw two or more picks. Two or fewer.
They'll try and start this drive in the air.
That's
caught on the left side by Kirk.
Wow.
And he takes this up to the 40.
I was eyeing that route the whole time. I was not.
Nice way to start the drive.
Time?
A gain of
12.
Yeah.
Early
enough. First
down.
The first carry down. This is Johnson. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Dude, come on. I mean, you left me no option. The right tackle literally just...
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or has moved away.
Get the yards for a decent
in this case, though,
man,
the team
come on, right tackle. We got a block.
Completion good.
Blindside, like... And they scored. I'm not surprised I fumbled. That's a blindside thing.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Open man is Kirk, complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. A gain of 6 there on first.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's
run, buddy. Come on. The
main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays. Run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath. Settle down and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
On guy face mask.
Down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage.
Nice catch. Buddy. Dang, that's
a fantastic. Into the hands of his tight end complete. And he's got this down to the 35. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. Now a fake on the give here as they try to
I'm pretty sure I
should
read that guy and I saw him, but I was like, fuck it.
Throw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down. On second down, Johnson.
Ooh, come on.
Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
There's no chance of even getting close.
Especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not.
Oh my.
Battle for it, it's intercepted.
Dude, they need to fix that. That's a joke. How they play the better out routes. Okay, well, I'm so used to old man's where out routes literally.
They go back to the air here after the INT.
Dude, see, like, why do you guys? Someone go 5 yards. Someone go 12. So they can't.
Crabtree there, and that'll bring up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Got.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side.
Number one.
11
right
yards there, first down. Now they have a little more space to maneuver from the 15, first and 10. Now a fake on the give here as they
oh
try
my God,
the
Harrison
pass option.
Smith.
And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. A gain of 6 there on first. 2nd and 4.
Oh, nice throw. I'm sure he'd make it that bad of a throw.
Andy Isabella was the intended target, and it's 3rd and 4. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Bird, and he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you, coming up at halftime, Charles, you want a way to enhance your Saturday?
I do.
I know you do. Got the thing just for you. It's the coach, Jonathan Goodrum, standing by in Orlando to take us through the weekend in the NFL. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and 12.
Over.
Wide open receiver complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 16 yards, a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Now this one to his running back.
Catch it with in stride. All you gotta do is
the Cardinals gonna use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. 2nd and 6. He gets it left side to Johnson.
Get out of bounds.
And they're well past midfield.
Dude, get out of bounds. Now I gotta do the stupid. Yep, it's a shell clock, my favorite.
First down.
This I know this is not a blitz.
11 to 15 through the air. Dude. Here's 1st and 10. Flush to his right.
Get away, man. Come on. Why does it make me stop? Jeez. Sometimes this game has like no logic.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Looking to throw.
Oh, P.I.? The fuck?
But it's incomplete. Charles Clay is tied in the intended target, but now it'll be 3rd down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And he can only manage to take this thing to the...
We didn't even make the field goal, dude, or take a field goal.
They'll try to get the offense
run outside. Look how open that is.
This defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along
with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
The question is, can this offense step up and make that?
No, we can't because our guys are too bad. Our offensive line can't block for enough times. And David Johnson is supposed to be good. He can't run, so.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
Christian Kirk, dude,
he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32. They'll set up a throw. Crabtree with it.
Run, man. They don't run in this game. They don't.
Well, that's a familiar connection right there. Christian Kirk was in the same class as Kyler Murray at Texas A&M. They played together as freshmen before Murray transferred. Kirk, though, he stayed in College Station.
I'm not
had a great
Kyler Murray,
three-year
man.
Career before being drafted 47th overall in 2018. Was having a solid rookie campaign last year, but then broke his foot in week 13 and was shut down the rest of the way. Now a nice
oh, that's not a fumble.
On first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Andy Isabella was the intended target, and now it's 2nd down. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And this is going to turn into another 1st down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 37. They'll set up to throw.
And you see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And now a throw on 1st down there, but it's incomplete. Another shot from the 9 on 2nd and goal. 2nd and 9 now.
And that's nice throw.
In the end zone, it's incomplete. The tight end, Max Williams, the intended receiver. But now it's 3rd and goal. Two incompletions haven't moved him any closer. And likely throwing again, you'd have to think on third.
Are you serious? And that's it. I didn't even get my touchdown. Well,
so the final seconds,
I didn't get my touchdown because like no one blocked. And it was their defense really paved the way to this victory
as they allowed the one touchdown, and that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the
trash. I'm way better than he is. So yeah, guys, that'll be the end of QB1 Face of the Franchise, Episode 6. That was just horrible. Didn't have a good game. Let's see what the coach has to say. I didn't get the passing touchdown because of not even a chance. Let's see. Yeah, guys, that'll be the end of Episode 6. ACL, JGP, Jake Boogram, or Jacob. Peace.